Bismillahi wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillahi wa ba'd. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back to this beautiful short series about Muharram, the sacred month of Allah. We were speaking about previously about the days of Allah, the ayyam Allah, and we mentioned that from those days of Allah, indeed, on the tongue of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, is Ashura, the 10th of Muharram. What we will now discuss is how not only is it has such an immense nature, but the nature of the day we want to discuss this time is about the immense maghfirah, forgiveness, that is available on this day. Let's give it some context. This is in the Jami' of Imam Tirmidhi. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is asked, which month would you command me to fast after the month of Ramadan? He's asked specifically, if I'm going to fast a month outside of Ramadan, which month should I fast? Look at what the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he says. He says, in kunta sa'iman ba'da shahr Ramadan. If you want to fast after the month of Ramadan, you want to target a month to fast, look at what he says, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, fasum al-muharram fa innahu shahrullah. Allahu Akbar. He said, fast al-muharram because it's the month of Allah. It's the month of God. And we discussed this previously. But the hadith goes on to say something very remarkable. And it's a message of hope for all of us, my dear brothers and sisters. Fihi yawman تاب الله فيه على قوم ويتوب فيه على قوم آخرين. That the hadith continues that in the sacred month of Allah, Shahrullah al-Muharram, is a day, yawman. Now the hadith doesn't make it expressive, but the ulama will extract from this that it's Ashura that the Prophet ﷺ is speaking about. In it is a day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave a whole people. And again, in the sharh of this hadith, it makes mention that this that's being alluded to here is the people of Jonah, Yunus alayhi salam, the people of Nineveh in Iraq. These are a people that on a day were fully, the whole qawm, the whole people were forgiven. They all aslamu, they all became Muslim, and they were all forgiven their sins as they became Muslims, all of them. But then you might say, okay, alhamdulillah, good for them. But look, this is now a message of hope. What the hadith goes on to say, وَيَتُوبُ فِيهِ عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ آخَرِينَ, and Allah will turn to a people to accept the repentance of people, other people, قَوْمًا آخَرِينَ, other people. Meaning, my dear brothers and sisters, that the day of Ashura, the 10th of Muharram, there's a huge opportunity for us to have our sins forgiven. In the same way we see in history that the people of Jonah, Yunus al-Islam, were forgiven. And they even say, the ulama will give riwayas, that not only that, Jonah himself, Yunus al-Islam, was freed from the belly of the whale, Batr al-Hut, on that day as well. This very significant day of God, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala freed Yunus al-Islam from the belly of the whale, but also his people became Muslim and had their sins forgiven. But there is an opportunity, my dear brothers and sisters, on that day for us to also turn to Allah and have our sins forgiven. May Allah give us the tawfiq to do exactly that. Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.